Hello friends, I am Hitesh. Welcome you all on our YouTube channel. Today we will going to discuss about implementing group technology and methods of part families grouping. So let's start with the contents of our topic. Number one, implementing group technology. Methods of part families grouping like visual inspection method, composite part method, production flow analysis, part classification and coding. So let's start with the implementing group technology. There are two major tasks that a company must undertake when it implements GT. Number one, identifying the part families. Number two, rearranging production machines into cells. So there are four methods for solving part families grouping. All the four are time consuming and involve the analysis of much of data by properly trained personnel. Which are methods? Number one, visual inspection method, composite part method, production flow analysis, and the last is parts classification and coding. In this video, we will discuss about first three methods. Parts classification and coding method we will discuss in the next video. So let's start with the first method. The first is visual inspection method. As the name says, the visual inspection method is the least sophisticated and least expensive method. It involves the classification of parts into families by looking either the physical parts or their photographs and arrange them into groups having similar features. As we see in the figure, similar shape or drawings components are arranged in a similar group. As we see in the figure, here are some more figures to understand the concept of visual inspection method. Although this method is generally considered to be the least accurate method among the other methods. Now moving on, the next method, that is the composite part method. In this method, a hypothetical composite part is formed on the basis of the features of all the components forming the group in a questions. Figures show the number of components manufacturing on a lathe, the various operations including setting the length, facing, turning, grooving, drilling, boring, rimming, counter boring, chamfering, etc. Each job need all the operations. An imaginary components is composed which involves all the operations needed for the group, as we show in the figure. Moving on, the next method, that is the production flow analysis method. This method makes the use of the information contained on route sheet rather than a part drawing. Work parts with identical or similar routing are classified into part families. Initially, a machine and component chart must be formed. This is something like a M cross N, yeah, M by N matrix, where M is the number of machines and N is the number of parts, where X is equal to 1 if parts J has the operation on the machine, I is known as 0, otherwise is maybe count off. If the machines and component chart is small, parts with similar operations might be grouped together by manually sorting of the rows and columns. As we see in this figure, the table show a PFA, means production flow analysis, to form the part families. Here on the X axis show the number of parts and the Y axis represent the machines. But if we discuss in the last slide, but when a component is small number of operations and small number of group, that we can do the manually by sorting the row and columns, but when the number of machines and operations are more, this is become a very complicated job. So friends, this is the entire discussion of three methods of implementing group technology. In this three methods we develop the part family grouping and their methods of part family cells. So friends, this is the entire discussion of implementing group technology and their three methods. Hope you understand all the points and its methods. We will meet you in the next video. Till then, take care. Thank you so much.